Hi guys, Michael Jensen here. Today I'll talk about streamers, and we're gonna tie a streamer. If you're into streamer fishing, streamer fly tying, you ought to get this book. It's the Bible on that topic, in my opinion. One of the flies I found in this book 20-25 years ago is Dan Bailey's Marabou Muddler. I tied a few of them back then, had a great success with them, but I ran out of the body material, which is this silver tinsel chenille. And for a lot of years, I couldn't find this material anywhere. A month ago, I found it on eBay in a shop in Poland, of all places. So now I tied a bunch of these Dan Bailey's white Marabou Muddler. Just a cool fly. If you want to tie the yellow winged version of this, you need this, which is a gold version of the same material. Today I'll show you how this fly swims underwater and how you tie it. Hang on. Okay, today I will try to speak a little while I do the tying. I'm not gonna tell you totally basic things that you know already, but there's a few sequences in this tying, in this fly here, where it might be helpful to get a little more information. This is a tinsel chenille, pretty hard to obtain, I found out, but it's made by Wapsi, so it should be available in the US and worldwide actually, but not many shops carry this. You can't really see it in this footage, but on some of these marabou feathers, I cut out the steam, the center steam of the tip of the feather, and tie it down like this. On some of the softest feathers, chickaboo feathers, I don't cut out the center, but leave the whole feather in. Okay, the recipe for this fly, according to Colonel Bates, is to use 9 pure pearls as the topping. So, just to keep things correct, I've actually counted 9 here. It really doesn't matter much, but it doesn't hurt. Here's a little tip. When you tie it in the peacock curl, they probably point straight up in the air, but you can put a bend into them by pulling the fibers over the edge of your scissors. And then there's deer hair. The first bunch, I keep tight pressure on the hair while I make the hairs flare. I don't allow them to roll around the shank. I do that with the rest of the hair.
a loose turn around and tighten up and let it roll. So you distribute it equally around the shank. That's not the only way to do it, but that's what works for me. I don't want to pack these deer hair heads too tight because this is not a surface buck. You want this fly to get down. You want it to push a lot of water, but you still want it to be able to suck in some water and get down onto the surface. That's it, no big head there, just a whip finish. That's the tying part, then it's cutting. I always start by cutting flat on the bottom. Of the head. That adds to the balance of the fly, make it swim through, and you get a free exposed hook point as well. After that, it's just, yeah, going at it. Cut the shape you like. I try to make a cone-shaped head on these often. Other ties prefer a more bullet-shaped head. Make sure you leave some of those long hair behind as a collar, the tips of the first bunch you tied in. That's about it. Put some thin lacquer, get into the thread there. Well, it's ready to go swimming.
That was Dan Bailey's White Marabou Muddler. Thanks for watching.